Absolutely, yes.
Okay, so everybody happy with you signing it? Okay, matters arising.
Thank you for that query. Yes, I did just want last night to the companies were no longer companies that were operating under contract with adult social services. That is in fact correct. However, as you stated, former directors of companies are involved in care. There is a piece of work that's been completed in relation to safeguarding issues that were highlighted in the ADA report, and I've just received today a draft version of that response, which looks at the issues in relation to the safeguarding concerns that were raised, but also looks at the issues in relation to some of the companies that were involved in the care as well and their background. That's necessitated some further work with the Care Quality Commission in relation to their role in terms of registering individuals and companies as suitable for this sort of work. So that report will be available to elected members as soon as I can agree with the leader that it's fit for release, then it will be released.
It is proved that there are directors that are still involved with that, and they can be attributed to being responsible for some of the dire happenings that have been brought to our attention in the ADA report. Is there a mechanism for having their contracts terminated, removed, or whatever?
The facts can be laid out, and we discuss those facts with the Care Quality Commission. They would then take a decision in relation to the fitness or otherwise of individuals to be involved in being responsible persons for the delivery of care. There are, as I say, a number of individuals that are involved, and we will be working closely with the Care Quality Commission to take that forward. So it really needs to go through the appropriate channels.
I hope you'll be in a position to look at withdrawing contracts or non-renewing contracts.
I think the difficulty we have is if the Care Quality Commission decides that someone is suitable as a responsible provider, individuals will be able to choose to go to that provider whether we contract with them or not. So what we want to do is work with the Care Quality Commission in relation to the suitability of those individuals rather than take this as a contract. It's much more about whether people, whether they contract for them or not, are properly safeguarded in services that are managed. So there will be information that I can share with members, and as I say, as soon as we get to go ahead to share that.
Sorry,
Madam Chair,
that will be distributed presumably before the next meeting of this committee. Would it be?
As soon as I can go ahead, I will share it. I haven't got a date for that yet. I have only just received the information today in relation to those safeguarding related issues. I have previously circulated some information in relation to those people named in the NKA report that are still involved in providing care. I would be perfectly willing to share it with this committee subject to agreement.
Okay. This is not on the agenda. Can I ask, have we got an update where we are with the petition for the last bit of surgery?
Yes, I was going to mention the vascular surgery review as that is arising. The last figure I have was the last figure that the petition that I submitted to the last council meeting, so it's around about 3,000. But there were still people collecting signatures, and I believe that is now an online petition. I haven't looked at the online petition, but it's certainly a significant number of signatures. I spoke spoke to Martin McEwen from the Cheshire, Warrington and Wirral Commissioning Board on Friday. He tells me that the public consultation is to continue until the 16th of June, after the elections. I've got a list of dates here. I'm very grateful to Councillor Wellbeing for his acknowledgement. Today, the 12th of March, tomorrow, the 13th of March at St Mary's Centre in Chester, Wednesday, the 14th of March at Bevington Civic Centre, 3 till 6, and then Friday, the 30th of March here in the Town Hall, 4 till 7.
Okay, yeah.
Other matters arising. the lips briefing, which was carried over from last week, the last time's meeting will be item 6 today on the agenda. We did have an item which was maternity services put new on the work programme. I have spoken to Phil James and we're going to bring it to the next committee meeting a report on that. I should apologise for that. I expected it would be Catherine Dora and Wood, but it's actually a commission. I'm changing the order of the agenda. I'm going to take item 7 along with item 11. Then I'm going to take items 9 and 10.